this ranking in nature that we have, that we say humans rank the highest, and then we have higher animals like chimpanzees, whales, and so on, and then at last comes flies, spiders, and so on, that this ranking has nothing to do with science. We know that flies, for example, move their legs while sleeping, perhaps while dreaming. There's a lot of things going on among animals. It's perhaps not about intelligence, but it's about emotions. And what is most important in our life? That are emotions. Think about love, happiness, and so on. And there, in emotions, which are the drivers of instincts, animals are very good. You find the love-driving hormone oxytocin that we have in our veins, that brings love to each other, to mothers, to their child, fathers, to their child, and so on. This hormone is also in the veins of goats, horses, and even in goldfish. What the hell does it in goldfish? Are they able to feel love? We don't know, perhaps. There are also examples of love between different species, for example, between ravens and wolves. And there, we think that we are the only ones who keeps pets, for example, like dogs or cats. We feel love for them, and most owners think, and I think they are right, that those dogs and cats love them too. But there are also examples between different animal species, like whales and seals, or cats and crows. There's a wonderful example described in the book about a crow which adopt a little kitten and feed it with rainworms, because otherwise it would have starved to death. So this love for even a different species is nothing special to human. I think we can't learn very much about animal behavior, because we behave like animals in a good sense. So we are still able to feel love, and we are still able to bring our emotions above our mind, which is a really good thing. I'm deeply convinced that love is more important than intelligence. What will all the intelligence be good for when you live in a world that, for example, Donald Trump is creating right now? When there would be a little bit more, although he is emotionally driven very hard, I would say. For me, it's more a question of more emotion and less intelligence. When you go out in the nature, always think that you don't watch birds or not just walk through a forest, but that you are interacting with all living species around you. And that's really funny.